students, so in the previous class we were talking about that of the availability of the oxygen. In the availability of the oxygen student, what we had discussed that how this oxygen is available inside that of the soil for the living organism which are living in that of the soil. So we discussed that inside the soil particles, they are loosely arranged, and since the soil particles are loosely arranged, there is a space between them, and these space present in them consisting of our air element. Now all the living organisms, including that of the animals, they take the air from the space between that of the soil, and this air consists of the oxygen. Okay, so if we talk about the earthworm students, so earthworm lives inside the soil. So in between that of the soil particle, the air which is present in it, the oxygen which is present in it, is used by the earthworm for the process of respiration. What about the plants? So one part of the plant, and that we call as a root of the plant, it also need to respire. And for respiration student, this root will take the oxygen, take the air which is present in between the soil. I told you that during heavy rainfall, what happened? These air which is present in between that of the soil will get filled by the water, and there will be no space for the air. So ultimately, the living organism comes outside. You have heard that during rain, the earthworm, you start seeing the earthworm and the other creatures which live inside the soil on the ground. Why is this so stupid? Because that pores which is present in the soil is now filled with the water. So for respiration, they need oxygen, and there is no oxygen present inside the soil. So ultimately, they have to come outside to take the oxygen from the surround. Same thing happened with the plants also. You see, we used to pour the water to the roots of the plant, but we should never fill the pot with a lot of water. Why is it so? Because ultimately what will happen, the excess amount of water will go into fill the pores which is present inside that of the soil, and root will be not able to respire. Ultimately, the root will die and the plant will also die. So this is the availability of the oxygen inside that of the soil. Now, availability of the oxygen in the water, students. So in the water, there is a dissolved oxygen is present, which is further used by the plants and animals for the process of respiration. Oxygen is dissolved in the water, and this oxygen is given by that of the aquatic plant by the process of photosynthesis. So they do the process of photosynthesis and release oxygen, which is further used by the aquatic animals. Then, now we will discuss the availability of the oxygen on the land. Before the student, yesterday we were talking about the activity, one of the activity in which we said that oxygen is what? It is a gas. And when we are seeing the availability of oxygen in the water, it means the water is present in the gas. So the activity is water, air is present in the water. Air is present in the water. Air is present inside the water, stream. So basically, by an activity, you can understand that air is present in it. So for that, you will take a beaker and you keep the water inside it. Okay, so when you take a beaker and keep it and pour water in it, and after that, what will happen with the help of a tripod stand, students? Then what will happen? You will get that the bubbles starts coming out of it. Okay, so this bubbles which is coming coming outside that of the water, it is basically tells that the water it consisting of air and the water consisting of air in it, and before burning it more, before providing heat to it, as you supplies the heat very early before boiling, the bubbles starts coming out of it. Basically, what happens, student? When you provide a heat to a water, then the solubility of that of the air in the water will becomes less, and finally, air will start coming out of the water. Okay, so the air which coming out of the water, it will comes in the form of a water bubble. So we can say that yes, air is present in that of the water. So this activity, when you heat water present in a beaker, very earlier or earlier, bubbles starts coming out of it, which proves that air, that water consisting of air. So much before boiling starts, the bubble starts coming out of it, which proves that this water consisting of air in it, students. And that is why when we discuss the availability of oxygen in that of the water, it means oxygen can or oxygen remains dissolved in the water. You know that it is very easily soluble in that of the water. Okay. Now, how this oxygen is replaced in that of the air? Oxygen replaced. In the air. So you see here, students, we knew it and we talked it many times that how oxygen is essential for us. And why oxygen is essential for us, student? Because we take oxygen to carry the process of respiration. You know that to get energy for anyone, either it is a plant or that of the animals. It means for all the living organisms, if they want to get energy, they need oxygen. And how, what is the process? That process is the respiration. It means to carry the process of respiration, oxygen is very essential, oxygen is very important. Now, you say, oxygen is there in the atmosphere, and we living organisms, including the animals, including the human beings, and that of the plant, they are continuously consuming the oxygen from the atmosphere, from the air. Then what will happen? The percentage of the oxygen will keep on decreasing. Okay? Because we are continuously consuming it. Okay? But you see that there is a thing which helps in replacing the oxygen in the air. Okay? And that process is the process of photosynthesis. And you know that process of photosynthesis is carried by that of the green plants. Okay, so we can say that green plants plays a very important role. It plays a very important role in carrying the process of photosynthesis.
synthesis.
So why photosynthesis is essential, students? We discussed that in the process of a photosynthesis, it helps in releasing a very important gas, a very important, a very essential gas for all the living organism, and that is oxygen. Okay, so we are continuously taking that of the consuming that of the oxygen and releasing the carbon dioxide. So the amount of the carbon dioxide will be more. So this carbon dioxide is again used by the green plants. They take this carbon dioxide and with the help of the carbon dioxide they prepare the food. So you can write it that with the help of the carbon dioxide plants prepare their food and finally releases a very important gas that is oxygen. Okay, so oxygen is replaced in the air due to the process of photosynthesis. Now you see this, not only all the living organisms including that of the plant and animal, but when you burn the fuel, it means burning of that of the coal, burning of that of the petrol or diesel or kerosene. These are what? These are the fuels. We can write it burning of fuels, which will include burning of carbon. Carbon means coal. So instead of writing here carbon, we can write it coal. Burning of coal. Then burning of petrol, diesel, kerosene. These are what? These are the fuel by which we burn it and use it. Okay, so these fuel, when they burn, they release a gas, and that gas is carbon dioxide. So you can understand, student, that we also expel carbon dioxide. All the living organism expel carbon dioxide by the process of respiration. And when we burn the fuel, this fuel will also help in producing the carbon dioxide in that of the atmosphere. So a lot of our carbon dioxide will be there, and this carbon dioxide will be again replaced by that of the green. They take up this carbon dioxide with the help of the process of photosynthesis. They prepare their food and finally they release the oxygen. Although plants, they show the process of photosynthesis only, in which they use carbon dioxide and release oxygen, but you know that they also show the process of respiration, in which they take up, they inhale the oxygen, they take oxygen and breakdown of the food happen, and finally energy is released and carbon dioxide is also released. So this carbon dioxide is released by the plant, released by the animals, released by the human mind, released by burning of the fuel in the atmosphere, but the process of photosynthesis help in replacing the oxygen upper, which is again done by that of the plant. So you see here, students, we need oxygen from the atmosphere, and the plants are the only which produces the oxygen, or which replace the oxygen by that of the carbon dioxide in the air. Okay, so it replaces oxygen in the air. So plants, they do the replacement of the oxygen, and we need oxygen. So ultimately, we are dependent on the plant for the oxygen. Okay, so plants are responsible for the production, and we are dependent on the this production. So we are dependent on the plants. So by this method, we can say that oxygen is replaced. placed in the air. Now we will talk about we had discussed a lot of things about the air, so thin air around us, how the air help in combustion, why how the different types of composition of that of the air, including the nitrogen, including that of the carbon dioxide, water vapor, smoke, dust particle. Now we will discuss that what are the different uses of the air. Uses. Different uses of air. So what are the different uses of the air, students? So the first and the foremost use, students, what happen if there will be no air? We will not able to survive. Why is it so? Because we take the air, we take the oxygen, which is a composition of which is a form of air, which is a gas which is present in the air, and we release the carbon dioxide. So the first thing that air helps us to breathe as oxygen is present in the air. Okay, not only oxygen, student, it will help in the process of photosynthesis, because the carbon dioxide present in the air will help in carrying that of the process of photosynthesis. So air helps us to breathe, it helps us to show the process of breathing. So no human can survive without that of the air, because of oxygen they need it, oxygen need for the survival. So ultimately what will happen, they need that oxygen to survive, and that is present in the air itself. Okay, so air, it is very helpful for us to breathe. Okay, second one, air helps to carry the process of photosynthesis. So you see here, student, how it help in carrying the process of photosynthesis, because you know that photosynthesis can occur by that of the presence of carbon dioxide, and if the carbon dioxide is there, the carbon dioxide is used up by the plant. This carbon dioxide is present in the air, so ultimately air helps in the process of photosynthesis also. Okay, so whether it is for breathing, whether it is for process of photosynthesis, air, oxygen or carbon dioxide, which is a part of the air, so this help in the process of photosynthesis as well as it help in the process of breathing or respiration. Okay, next one is food, that is air helps in burning of fuels. Okay, so the fuels that we use to burn, by which we, with the help of that fuel that we burn, which help in cooking also. So this can be done by burning the fuel. When you burn the fuel, what will happen? It will produce heat, and that heat we can use for cooking purpose. Okay, so air help in burning of the fuel. What kind of a fuel, student? It can be coal, it can be kerosene. Okay, so kerosene or coal, these are the different kind of a fuel which we burn it with the help of the air. So air help in burning of the fuel, students. How? You see, air consisting of oxygen. So this oxygen is used up. This fuel, they with the help of the oxygen, they burn and produces energy, produces heat, which is used for cooking. So we can say that fuels used up oxygen for burning and day, it can be further used for cooking. Okay. No fuel can burn without air. Okay. So air plays a this much important role that fuel cannot be burned without air. Because you know that air consisting of oxygen. This oxygen will be used by the fuel for burning, and finally we can use it for the cooking purpose also. Next one is students. The compressed air is used to fill the tires of the vehicles. Okay, and this vehicles, you see the tires of the vehicles, it is filled with that of the compressed air, and finally this will help in giving us a smooth movement for that of the tire of vehicle students. So we can write it, the compressed air.
Get dispersed from one place to the another, and there
if it moves to the another base, there they germinate and then there is a formation of a tree at that other place. So air helping the dispersal of the seed and pollen grains. Next one is the air help in the then it will help in the movement of parachutes. So parachutes, then gliders, as well as it will help in the movement of that of the aeroplane. So we will write it aeroplanes. So because of the movement of the air only, parachute, sailing boats, that the boats with the help of which used to sail in the over the sea waves, that is sailing boats, parachutes, gliders and aeroplanes, all these they depend on the movement of the air. So the air, it helps in the movement of these things. Not only these students, but the air also helps in flying of birds, bats, okay, insects. Okay, so not only with that of the aeroplane or the parachutes or the gliders, but the living organism also which flies, especially that of the bird or the bat or the insects, they can also fly because of the air. So basically what happens to them when they fly, they with the help of their wings, they used to push the air in a downward. Okay, as they push the air downward, air will also exert a force in an upward direction. So they push the air in a downward and backward. Okay, so as they push the air backward and downward, air will also push it to upward and forward, and due to which it is able to move. Let me write it, that they pushes the air with the help of their wings downward and backward. So with the help of the wings, students, they used to push the air downward direction and backward direction, and ultimately air will also push it in the upward direction and the forward direction. Okay, and air will push it to upward and forward direction. Okay, so by this method, students, you can say that air helps in the flight of the bird. Okay, when they move with the, you see the, when they flap with the help of the wings. So when they flap the wing in the downward direction, the air will also make them to move in the upward direction. So by this method, you can see the flying of the bat as well as that of the insects. Then next use is that air is used in the process of water cycle. Air plays a very important role in the water cycle. How to this? You see the water in the form of a water vapor when you provide the heat. Now this water vapor is what? It is the hot air. It is the lighter one. So what will happen when the water surface become hot? It will get converted into water vapor. So that is how hot air and lighter air, so it will rises up. As it rises up, students, it will get condensed and forms the cloud. Okay. Now the cloud used to move from one place to another place, and air plays a very important role in carrying the cloud from one place to another. And after that, what will happen? These clouds will mix it with the other clouds consisting of a tiny droplet of water, and finally it will cause the rain. Okay, so we can say that for rain to occur, air also plays an important role in carrying the clouds from one place to another. So we can say air carries the cloud from one place to another and thus causes rain. Thus it causes rain. Okay, so it also plays a very important role in that of the water cycle. Finally, student, air help in rotating the windmill. Windmill is used for pumping the water. Windmill is used in the flooring mills, as well as it is also very important. The windmills, it help in generating the electricity. So we can say air plays an important role in rotating the windmill. Windmills helps in carrying out water, then water with the help of the pumps, then in flooring means, as well as to generate electricity. Okay, so in generating electricity, in flooring means, as well as in the carrying out the water pumps, students, water pumps, this plays a very important role. Basically, what happens when the windmill rotate? This windmill, as it rotate, it will make the crank to rotate, which is attached with it, and finally the water pump will carry the water from that water. Okay. As well as students, you have heard about the windmills. When the air strike on the windmills, the windmill starts rotating, and finally it will help in generating the electricity. So these are the different uses of air.